On the medical watch, a critical finding about an Alzheimer's drug.
Our medical reporter Dina Baer shows you how local scientists made the discovery.
There has been progress. The latest Alzheimer's drug appears to tackle the characteristic features of the disease in the brain. But local scientists make a finding that could make it even better.
I'm a neuroimmunologist, so my passion is looking at immune cells.
Lynn Van Alst left the Netherlands and brought her expertise to Chicago to study Alzheimer's, particularly the role our immune cells play in the mind-robbing disease. In her latest study, she looked at multiple brain samples from a failed clinical trial and one from a more recent patient.
Then we also had one brain treated with one of the newer drugs that is actually on the market right now.
The new drug is called lecanemab. It's designed to clear away the amyloid beta plaques known to play a role in Alzheimer's disease. You can see the clumps here in brown.
We don't want to advocate pro or con these treatments. What we wanted to do is understand how they work in the brain, which genes are involved, so that we can improve them.
There is room for improvement.
We're making a map of the brain.
With the help of a new tool that serves as a sort of GPS of the brain, the research team tracked where the plaques were removed and identified which genes were activated to clear the toxic substances.
On the bottom, we have the map that has a little text at different locations, and at the top we have the brain, and we put them on top of each other.
The team studied one of the first brains available from a deceased subject who received the new anti-amyloid drug. Days after her last lecanemab infusion, the patient appeared to be having a stroke, and doctors administered a common stroke treatment known as TPA.
So she came in with these stroke-like symptoms, and they treated her for that. And the treatment that they give for her at that moment, we know right now, doesn't go well with the drug.
Yeah.
But at that moment, that information was not available.
Lecanemab did, in fact, activate immune cells that then cleared the amyloid plaque from the patient's brain.
You see these immune cells are really toppling over to remove it.
Orange represents immune cells gobbling up plaque after the anti-amyloid treatment. That's a good thing. But the cells go even further, negatively impacting blood vessels.
They start surrounding those blood vessels that have this amyloid beta build up. And you see they're really surrounding it. We believe that these immune cells at the blood vessels might have a key role in the side effects to these drugs, and we're going to try to understand that better by looking into brains that have these side effects, that experience these side effects.
Genetic factors also play a role, specifically a variant known as APOE4. Another nuance, while the treatment did work to remove amyloid plaque from the brain, it did not appear to stop the spread of what's called tau pathology. Tau is a toxic substance that's closely linked to cognitive decline in Alzheimer's disease.
We think that either this treatment is not specific enough or not early enough. We don't know which of the two it is, so we know what kind of genes are active right here. Our second question is, what kind of genes are active right here? And if we know that, can we then make these drugs a little bit better and a little bit more specific?
The team is not working with the drug's maker. This is an independent research project using donated brain tissue. In their next study, the researchers plan to take a closer look at the cells and genes involved in attacking the blood vessels in people who have side effects following treatment. Back to you.